Kuchlu, Ukola Kusubu, Masalas, and Tabla Koshova, Kabala Boost.
Thank you. Thank you. Hey guys, I promised you more intersections and I'm delivering. Look at this beauty. I've got to say, this is actually my favorite. I love how this looks. This is called a three. Three-way directional stack intersection. And just look, I mean, that's beautiful. And I'm going to show you how to build it. Okay, so let's get started. Pick up our good old friend, the low density dirt road, and our magic number that we're going to be working with is 585. So we draw a straight line from our center point, 585, 584, 584 will do. And the same this way, 584 that way. Then we extend this one, doesn't matter how far, and then we join this up. Now, the nice thing about this is that you can only have the correct angle as a maximum. So if you take it up to just the point where it says it's too sharp, and then come down from that, that is the exact right angle anyway. So And then we join this up. Now, 585, 584, 584 will do. And same this way, 584 that way. Then we extend this one, doesn't matter how far. And then we join this up. Now, the nice thing about this is that you can only have the correct angle as a maximum. So if you take it up to just the point where it says it's too sharp, and then come down from that, that is the exact right angle anyway. So you kind of can't do this wrong. You can just double the magic number, but that's what you get anyway. So there you go. I do try to make this nice and simple for you. Now, you'll notice that when you've got the grid lines laid out, that you've got these two which point to this exact spot on each side, right? And that is the exact midpoint, and that's why we use this 585 number, because it gives us that exact midpoint. Right? So from there, hold down your shift key so you get 90 degrees. Boom. Now we can get rid of everything except our three lines in the center, because that's what we're actually working on. Because what we need is this correct angle here, so that each of the rows is heading in the right direction. Now, we trim these back so that we just leave the stub on each side. Okay, so there you go. That's all of that was just to obtain this density street, and I'm just going to extend looks parallel roads to create our like semi highways. So what we do is we put in another low density street parallel to these roads, and you want to put it on the same side each time so that they're correct in relation to each other. So I'm going to put this one on the left hand side. That looks okay to me. Again, if it's slightly off, it's actually not going to make any difference. So let's do the same with these. So I put that one on the left, so this one's going to go on the left as well. Good to me. Let's take a look. Yep, that looks good. And the last one, again, need to put this on. And we need to put this on the left, so zoom a bit. Boom, lovely. Okay, so now we've got our converging highways. So, step one completed. Right, on to step two. Now, step two, we switch over to our favourite, the arc tool that I always get wrong. And all we're going to do is put in a curve connecting the right hand lane to the left hand lane on the opposite side, on the right hand side. Yeah, I can't think of a better way of phrasing that. Now, again, you want to draw these the same way each time. So go from the right-hand lane to the right-hand lane so that you always get the same curve from each fake highway to the next. So, again, low-density street, and I'm coming from the right, going to the right. Because you see, like, depending on exactly where you are and how you approach it and how you hook it up, you'll get different curves. So, you know, you want to come out straight and then come into it as straight as possible. And then the same with this one. So I'm going from the right-hand lane, come out straight and go right, as straight as possible, and bump. And there we go. That's step two. Okay, so the next thing to do is to put in our spurs so that we can put in our bridges for the left-hand turns. So we've got the right hand, obviously, just goes to the right on each occasion. Right-hand turn. So we need the left-hand turn, and for that we need to create some little spurs. Now these are free draw, but you can use the streetlights as a guide. Okay, so there's usually a street light by here, and you want to judge it so that it's a bit, like if that's the width of a street light, then you want it about 2 to 2.5 street lights. Again, kind of doesn't matter to be too precise, but the more precise you can be, the better. Okay, so we're going to put in. So that's about a half. From there to there is about a half. So I want 1, 2, see. And then I'm going to come out at 45 degrees. And you want this to be around sort of like the 250 mark. Round about there. Okay. Now, you can test out whether this is going to work, because you're going to join this to this road here. Now, it helps. It actually helps to make the bridge. So I'm going to raise this by 4, 1, 2, 3. Okay. And I'm going to bring it around here. Now you'll get angle too sharp. So what you do is you move it up this road until it says something other than angle too sharp, okay? And it's that point, it changes from angle too sharp to cannot intersect this road. And the reason it's saying that is because we've still got this center point in. But I want to make sure that at the point where it changes, okay, so from angle too sharp to cannot intersect this road, that we're crossing this center point as close as possible. If you're not, right, like if you're too far this side, okay, then it means this is pointing too far this way. Okay? If you're too far the other way, so if you're that side, which I can't really do, it means that this is pointing too much this way. Okay? So by controlling the angle of this, and when you play around with it, you'll find it's actually pretty easy to judge. You want this so that it crosses that center point when you get to that point where you can connect the rub, which is there, about there. Okay, and as you can see, it's crossing that center point, so that's great. Okay, so now we know that that's working. We'll get rid of that. Now, this is quite important. The height of the road, here we go, there, about there. This is pointing too far. That is because we've
Czarnuk de Charo Kimoflapkin.
Thank you.